actually for such an hectic program yesterday that we have completed, and today we have to come so early morning, and I'm really tired right now.
So it's 6:45 a.m. and we are here at Lal Bagh, and everyone's complaining saying we were called here early. So the reason we've got them here is, you know, to show the beauty of the trees amongst us, the city. You know, so Lal Bagh is like this pocket in the city which has a lot of beautiful trees. So we want to show the participants these trees and, you know, inspire them to look at these trees and create better aquascapes. Hopefully the participants take a lot more than what we came here for.
It's the strangler fig.
No. Strangler fig.
No, that one overgrown.
Which one?
Newer.
It's all the same plant. Choosing your plants in an aquarium, be careful as to where you're putting what. Some other plant might take over if it's taller, not give the other plant light. It's always a battle for light and resources, right?
It's a kind of looking like a cup or some kind of utensil.
So this particular tree is called the Ficus Krishnae. Okay. And rumors go that, I mean, this is again a mythological thing that is there, that Krishna used to store his, you know, butter inside this thing, hence the name Ficus Krishnae. You go. Do you feel the difference? The grass here.
Lal Bagh walk.
So we started very early today, and then we went to Lal Bagh garden, and it was quite intriguing and quite refreshing, because I have not seen a park which is with such heavy jungles, and we seen good examples which we could have reflect those with our day-to-day aquascaping work.
Able to look at the beautiful plants and different variety of trees and other species. Our sir also explained about the different types of trees which are very old.
So I had been going to Lal Bagh for ages. Every year at least 25-30 times I go there. But today I got to see and got to observe many things which I could have not even imagined that it exists in Lal Bagh.
Just not like going and just walking around in a park and just feeling, okay, I'm in the midst of nature. But today we had a whole new experience of observing each and every plant there, whether there is any peculiarity in that. And also we identified many things which were not actually visible to the common eye.
We looked at Lal Bagh in a different way with respect to the aquarium part of it, what an aquascape is we would look at. The green grass we were looking at as a garb and
these things, and just knowing that it's there's still part of it in the city. It's nice. We need more of this, not just, you know, given no consideration for. We need more nature in the city. We need to live with it.
Less water, more plants outside the water. But the plants need to stay humid. The key. We give you a packet of flame moth each to tie on the wabi mat. I will give you maximum 2 hours to finish.
So now we're getting the contestants to do the Terra 30 setup. Terra 30 is a fairly new concept from ADA, and it involves skill in putting a vertical garden into an aquarium and having a little water with creating a beautiful ecosystem with water and plants growing submerged as well as immersed. So the ambassadors have about 2 hours to finish their creation, and I believe it's a challenge for them to do what they're doing, and should be interesting. Let's wait and watch.
Mr. Kamli has already started pouring the soil. Atharva is already getting the stones in place. What is the idea you have to escape?
I have the idea is the roots style. So in the end of the session, we will see the style of roots. Thank you.
So basically, what I'm trying a small land of rock, and there are some driftwood which is laying off there, and probably I'm trying to fit in this. I need to cut it down, but let's see how it turns out at the end.
So my idea is to make some deep looking forest which has some immersive feeling.
Wall pad I have finished. No hardscaping I am doing, so I need to go with the nubias on the driftwood.
The wall is almost done, and I am trying to create a base with plants with mixed up colors, like in a balance, which hope becomes like when you view it, it's in harmony.
Time is of the essence as always. Yesterday wasn't good with time, so I'm not getting distracted, making some eyes out. I don't want to pay attention anyway.
That's
by talking to the camera, I'm taking my eyes off. Not good.
So, Atosh, what's going on? I'm a
little confused. Moss, puro nahi hai, proper sahi hai.
Acha.
Tape laga deta hai, Terra tape.
Very good. So, you're happy with what you've done?
Yeah.
You seem to be leading now. Everyone's eyes are on you.
Amount of area empty at the front, so I can add some fish and they can swim and have their fun. Thank you.
So guys, this is the basic setup. It's roots over the rock, and I have used the java fern and java moss, as well as the flame moss, as well as the anubias in between the rocks and the wood.
If you were to ask me to name it, I'd probably name it Sticks and Stones. Yeah, I've tried to keep it simple, a little minimalistic, and my way of doing it is I don't like it too much to be aesthetically what pleases our eye, but what nature gives us instead.
Different perspective where we can see the forest region with the more dense rocks and roots coming out than the background trees and all. So I have used less plants over the background and everything more dense and in the foreground.
This is a very simple setup I did. It is against a backdrop of a tree on rock as fallen, and there is a small jungle, and on the tree some trees are grown, plants or trees.
So this design came to my mind last night. I was thinking that if I want to go and sell it to some corporate or I want to market it, then what extra I can do apart from being artistic. So I try to create the Amano A here. Okay, so I think in future it will be much better. So my basic idea is that, okay, greenery is there, what extra I can add on to a company. So my thought process is that if I can make use the plants and make a logo or initials, a name of a person, if it is a birthday or it is a marriage anniversary, then I can sell it much better. So that thought process I try to incorporate it.
Already the Terra base is mainly highlighted by the back wall. So I try to do some justice by doing something more in the front. That is what I did. I like the driftwood coming out. See the plants which I have arranged here, like in nature there is nothing like everything is arranged in a way like that. So just spread it out in whatever way you like.
Day 2, started on the Terra 30, completed that, a nice timed contest.
And today there were no teams, we were all split up into 8, we were given Terra 30 each,
which I believe all of us performed a whole lot better.
That was my first full escaping I have done.
And a wonderful session that I really enjoyed was the one that we had with Hargo that followed, about the fishes, understanding their morphology, physiology, why their colors change, what it takes to do that, the feeding and the genetics and you know the environment that they're in.
We are met up with again Professor Nagendra sir, who is very resourceful and very rich in the knowledge.
It was basically upon how we can be more have a structured approach for our hobby. And it was a good learning experience.
This was a very awesome topic. It was a very informative. This was very informative and he told us what is a philosophy, like a Japanese philosophy, Swiss philosophy, and very, very various type of philosophy that will be become a good ambassador, good man.
I'm excited about the tomorrow's visit.